working in the spirit of Texas. From WFAA TV, this is the News 8 Update.
Dallas City Manager Jan Hart goes before her bosses for a critical review. Good evening and thank you for joining us. Chip is off tonight. Jan Hart has been under fire since she chose a new police chief without consulting council members. Tonight, the city manager's job was on the line. Channel 8's Dave Evans joins us live now from City Hall with details. Dave?
Well, I think that they have been waiting until we're into the 10 o'clock news right now, and I see that Mayor Steve Bartlett and Jan Hart are coming out of the meeting just over my right-hand shoulder. And council members that we have talked to so far seem to be saying that the review process for Jan Hart went well and that they are pleased with it. Three council members asked for the review, and I think that Steve Bartlett, the mayor of the city, is having a few things to say to reporters just over my right shoulder. If you can go ahead and clip and just take a picture of the mayor talking with different reporters just a couple of yards away from my where I am now. If we could go ahead and take some pictures of what happened, though, a week ago that sparked the review process. Three council members asked for the review, and last week one of them, Don Hicks, publicly lambasted Hart, calling her the queen and saying she employed Gestapo Nazi-like tactics in hiring a new police chief from Phoenix. Mayor Steve Bartlett denied he was trying to get rid of Hart, even though several council and former council members say the mayor is not telling the truth, that he has shied away from this issue once it became apparent how popular Hart is with most of the council members. Once again, they have come out of this review process. Right now, as we're speaking, we'll have more for you in just a little bit. Tracy?
Okay, Dave, thank you. Guilty is the verdict tonight in the trial of a Frisco girl charged with her mother's brutal murder. It took a Collin County jury less than 2 hours to convict 17-year-old Chrissy Caldwell of capital murder. Witnesses say the girl solicited hitmen to murder her parents at their Frisco house because they did not approve of her relationship with Robert Gonzalez. Gonzalez has received two prison sentences for solicitation and capital murder convictions. Caldwell did not testify in her own trial. She's received an automatic life sentence without parole for 35 years. Fort Worth police plan to charge a driver with attempted capital murder tonight after a high-speed chase that sent an officer to the hospital. The chase began in East Fort Worth when a suspected drunk driver in a Ford pickup tried to force a squad car off the road. Police chased the pickup for 30 minutes to DFW Airport. The pickup rammed into a marked squad car, and the driver bailed out of the truck. A Fort Worth officer apprehended the driver, but in the process, the officer dislocated his shoulder. The officer tonight is in good condition. A Dallas lawyer tonight says television evangelist Robert Tilton is defying a judge's order and should be held in contempt of court. The case involves a Dallas widow who says Tilton sent promises of healing and miracles to her husband long after the man was dead. Here's more tonight from Channel 8's Bill Brown.
I remember him putting his hand against the TV screen as Mr. Tilton prayed for someone with a liver problem.
Norma Smith says as her husband, Tommy Lee, lay dying, he turned in his final desperation to TV minister Bob Tilton. Smith sent what little money he had to the preacher, and soon after, he died. But months later, his widow says, Tilton was still sending her husband mail offering miracles for money. As others did, Norma Smith sued Tilton. Citing freedom of religion under the Constitution, Tilton refused to answer some questions or to turn over church financial records. Dallas District Judge Eric Morier ordered the preacher to produce the documents by 4 p.m. Wednesday. The deadline passed. No papers were produced. Smith's lawyer says Tilton is stonewalling.
I will ask the judge for either sanctions, such as striking their defenses, granting us a declaratory judgment.
Which means you win.
We win, they lose. Are ordering them to produce the documents here at this office and are holding Mr. Tilton in contempt.
If the judge finds him in contempt, could he go to jail?
Certainly.
Tilton's Dallas lawyer, Rhonda Byrd, did offer to let the lawyer see some records in her office. When they went over to meet with her, Byrd told him the Texas Supreme Court had just issued a stay, barring Judge Moyer's order. Wright said he'd like to see it on paper. Byrd wouldn't speak with us. Tilton could not be reached. Wright says if they did get a stay, it wasn't until almost 2 hours after the deadline, so Tilton should still be held in contempt. It appears the Smith trial now will be delayed by all this. Both sides, meanwhile, start meeting with a mediator on Thursday. That could bring a settlement. Bill Brown, Channel 8 News.
Well, we understand that Jan Hart now is standing by with Channel 8's Dave Evans. Let's go back to City Hall. Dave?
Well, Tracy, with me now is Jan Hart, who just came out of the two-hour-long review process. Basically, the question is, how do you think it went?
I think it went well. Had a lot of good, positive discussion with the council. I think that generally they feel like I'm doing a good job, and that makes me feel very good and feel very good about the organization and city employees in particular.
Do you feel vindicated at all, though, in tonight? Because most of the council members have told me in breaks that your future seems secure, that it never was really in that much of doubt.
Well, I think that I feel this way about just all relationships with councils, and that is that it's important to have regular reviews. And maybe they need to come more frequently than once a year, which is when they do, because, you know, it provides for better ongoing communication. So I thought it was a very good review.
Did Don Hicks back down?
It wasn't an issue of anybody backing down about anything. We had a good, healthy discussion about it. We both clearly, I think, have the same goals for the city, and that is to make the city the best place that it is. And we're going to continue to have discussions, but just move on.
I see the mayor is here with me now. Can we say that things have patched up basically between both of you now?
Things were not a problem to begin with. That's what we've both been trying to explain to you for the last 2 weeks.
And you agree with that, Jan?
Well, I think that we're committed to working with the council members and with each other and with staff, and that's what our jobs are, and we're going to do that.
Is this behind you, Steve?
It has been for some time. This was a no-news kind of night, and that's what both Jan and I tried to communicate, but I guess people love the conspiracy theory and the idea that somebody's shooting and hollering and negative, and it wasn't that way at all. In fact, this session was a very candid session. Jan and I discussed maybe we should have had it a long time ago, in fact, and she said maybe we should have it more frequently. Gave council members a chance to say things that they needed to say, gave the manager a chance to communicate things she needed to communicate, and I think it really will give us a better city government and a better city council.
Okay, thank you for talking to us. All right. That's Mayor Steve Bartlett and City Manager Jan Hart saying that this is basically patched up, that things are put behind Steve Bartlett and Jan Hart, and they're trying to move ahead. This sounds as if it went pretty well for Jan Hart this evening. Back to you, Tracy.
Okay, thank you very much, Dave. Well, it could not have been closer, though, when the House of Representatives finally decided the fate of the space station today. By only a one-vote margin, House lawmakers on Capitol Hill spared the big Houston-based project, even as opponents labeled it as this flying turkey. The vote authorizes spending about $13 billion on the space station in the next 10 years. The new design and specific appropriations for next year will soon face still another test in the House. And that close vote has supporters of the Super Collider wondering what their science experiment faces tomorrow. In a tune-up for tomorrow's big vote, debate began in the House this afternoon on the Collider's future. As project construction continues, Collider boosters are battling the odds. A year ago, the project lost a big vote in the House, even as construction continued.
But almost one-third of the members of this body are new. And more significantly, new information is being made available every day, like the DOE Inspector General's report on SSC excess spending.
We have a responsibility to our children. We've talked about the waste of money. This is an investment. I would urge you and plead with you, do not pull the plug on our future.
Even if the House votes tomorrow to kill it, the Collider still could win new life in the Senate, and that's what happened last year. And the Senate tonight did kill a GOP alternative to President Clinton's deficit reduction plan. After months of work, Republicans just this afternoon finished their own budget proposal. Using props, Senator Bob Dole illustrated the No New Taxes plan. But the president called the proposal a scheme that shields the rich from paying what he called their fair share. Clinton today lobbied those in his own party who are still undecided in hopes of getting their support for the Clinton budget plan. And in a surprise vote, the Base Closure Commission today rejected Pentagon recommendations to close Fort McClellan in Alabama and Fort Lee in Virginia. The panel did not vote on any Texas bases today. But a decision could come tomorrow on whether Carswell Air Force Base in Fort Worth should be used as a reserve air training center. The fate of Texas Kelly Air Force Base in San Antonio, the Ingleside home port, and the Corpus Christi Naval Air Station will likely be decided on Friday. A decision on the Dallas Naval Air Station, largely contingent on the Carswell vote, is expected this weekend. Now still to come on tonight's update, allegations of sexual harassment and physical abuse put a local correctional facility under court scrutiny. Plus, two Dallas theaters are slapped with hefty fines for showing certain movies. And our nation's 14th state is put on an endangered list of as preservationists work to save its rustic charm. We'll have details later in tonight's newscast.
Well, Saturday night, you know it's customary for a wild and woolly cowboy to ride to town.
Let's ride to town.
Your Ford dealer just received a special shipment of emerald green F-150 Supercabs. Specially painted and well-equipped, one can be yours for just $2.99 a month with Ford Credit's customer option plan. But you better hurry, because they're going fast. Plus, get a crisp new cassette just for stopping by your North Texas Ford dealer.
The produce of the season. You can buy it at any store, or you can buy it at a great one.
You can shop at 1,000 stores, but there's only one that's yours.
The finest fresh produce and honest low prices.
Albertsons, it's your store.
On the next Entertainment Tonight.
I don't disdain Hollywood or my Hollywood friends.
E.T. has your exclusive tour to see how superstar Harrison Ford gets away from it all, down home on his Wyoming ranch.
It's a way of simplifying my life.
When he's not running around making blockbuster films, you'll hear how he's making a safe haven for endangered eagles. We're hanging out with Harrison, only on the next Entertainment Tonight.
Tonight at 10:35 here on Channel 8.
What could possibly improve Mozart's Divertimento in D? How about seven speakers, an 8-inch subwoofer, and 180 watts of sound? The 1993 LS400. Hear it now at your Dallas-Fort Worth area Lexus dealer today.
Este noticiero es transmitido simultáneamente en español por Latin 107 FM.
Tarrant County's boot camp comes under the review of criminal district judges who will be meeting tomorrow. The 18 judges will investigate allegations of sexual harassment and physical abuse of inmates at the Mansfield facility. The military-style camp provides counseling and drug treatment for first-time nonviolent offenders. The Tarrant County District Attorney launched an investigation into the camp after more than a dozen complaints that guards were harassing female inmates. Judges say they did have some concerns about the allegations.
I did, of course, when I first found out about the information. We all do, and we still do. But I feel confident that all our concerns are going to be addressed and solved.
Judge Drago says he hopes to continue to send about 24 offenders each month to the boot camp. Some judges have temporarily stopped sending people to the boot camp until the problems there are solved. A controversy is brewing tonight over the Dallas Motion Picture Classification Board. It recently fined two Dallas movie theaters for showing movies the board had not cleared. Channel 8 movie critic Gary Cogill watched a debate today at Dallas City Hall over the movie ratings board, and he found even Shakespeare isn't immune.
If you're going to classify movies, then you better start classifying books, newspapers, television programs.
The debate between the city-funded Dallas Motion Picture Classification Board and the Motion Picture Association of America rages on. Not in front of the city council, but in the hallway at City Hall.
We've got these busybodies around trying to tell people what they can see and can't see. You don't have any business doing that. The First Amendment guarantees freedom of expression.
Currently, every MPAA-rated film shown in Dallas must be filed with the Dallas Classification Board. The board recently exercised its muscle and served $2,000 in fines to the Inwood Theater for showing four films without filing the proper paperwork.
We plan to contest it, and we'll be engaging legal counsel to do so.
So at this point, you would say, I'm not going to pay the fine.
That's correct.
The General Cinema Galleria Theater was also fined for showing Like Water for Chocolate without filing. General Cinema immediately pulled the film.
If we're trying to bring distributors and film houses into Dallas, I think it sends the wrong kind of message. If people can't show their films without undue harassment or ticketing or city ordinances, I think they'll go to the suburbs.
Dr. Fred Auerbach heads the local Dallas Movie Classification Board. He feels they need to provide parents even more information.
We're adding an I for indecent behavior. We're adding an A for adult situation, and then a little DS for deviant sex.
That brings up the age-old question, why would the city re-rate films that have already been rated by the MPAA?
The fact is that I don't think currently Hollywood's doing a particularly good job of policing their own movies. The standard of what a PG-13 is a lot different than what it was even two or three years ago.
The war of the ratings moves inside council chambers on August 11th to approve or disapprove, to fine or not to fine. Movie ratings are the question. Gary Cogill, Channel 8 News.
Well, I guess if you're going to rate the weather, you'd have to give it a pretty high mark. It was hot, but it's supposed to be. It's summertime.
You don't have to file it with any board or anything.
I guess. Maybe
I do. Today, the weather was hot and humid. As you know, if you stepped outside, the heat index is about 100. Well, it'll be like that again tomorrow. But then we may have increasing chances for showers the next couple of days. And we'll talk about that, among other things.
Live captioning of News 8 is funded in part by Deloitte & Touche, providing auditing, tax, business, and management consulting services to North Texas for more than 70 years.
A lot of people say, what the big old ornery lineman they used to call the master, doing talking about trucks on TV. Well, I like to talk about things I believe in. And in case you haven't heard, the Chevy Half-Ton is the number one selling truck in Texas. It's got better resale value than a Ford. And since it's a Chevy, that makes it the most dependable, longest-lasting truck on the road. Oh, there's one other reason I like my Chevy.
Nice truck, Randy.
The leg. I mean the leg room.
Thanks.
The best thing about Tom Thumb stores is the friendly people. Tom Thumb wants their employees to be helpful. And I'm helpful. I like customer service. I do. I like what I'm doing. I guess because I'm a people person.
This week at Tom Thumb, you'll find nice and soft tissue at a nice and soft price, only 69 cents. Pick from a selection of Kraft salad dressings, just 59 cents a bottle. And there's big savings on Green Giant canned vegetables, 4 for $1.
Yeah, I had to know a little bit about everything in the store. I even carry out groceries.
My grandpa and I come to Chili's for the fajitas all the time.
That's my boy. Smart as a whip.
Delicious chicken and beef fajitas that are lots of fun to eat.
He's going to be a doctor someday, maybe even president.
And we put all kinds of good things on them, like cheese and pico de gallo.
Takes after me.
And after my good old grandpa pays a check. He always lets me keep the change.
Of course, he's got a lot of his grandmother in him, too.
Is that my dollar?
Nope.
I gotta go. I got another call.
I'm Larry Bonadonna, territory sales rep.
He just walked in off the street.
Like a stray dog.
Rochelle is the controller for
M&J Trimming.
When he first came, I said, give me an offer, write it down.
They need proof.
He wrote it down and he stuck to it.
MCI started a new program.
Company puts it in writing. This is what she'll be saving.
Your calling patterns change. We're gonna be able to credit you.
We're gonna call it proof positive.
Other suppliers don't do what Larry has done for me.
Proof positive.
I always knew I was a good guy and now I can prove it.
Kind of a quiet night out there. No weather activity around. It's a little bit breezy, but it's kind of a hot wind at that. Have a look at the radar for the last 2 hours, and we'll note that there's just no activity around the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Some big thunderstorms that caused high winds in the northeastern corner of Oklahoma are still there in the northern part of Arkansas, but they've diminished somewhat. Thundershowers continue in the south-central part of Louisiana. These storms right here caused wind gusts of 60 to 70 miles an hour at Miami, Oklahoma, east of Bartlesville in the northeastern corner of that state, but nothing around us. Tomorrow, maybe a little better chance. This is my overnight forecast for you then. These thunderstorms continue to die out overnight. Showers in the south central, southeastern part of the state are there, but not nearly as many as there were before. 74 for us by morning. Cool front gets a little closer tomorrow, so does a low pressure trough accompanying it, and so I think we'll see a thunderstorm break out in Oklahoma and maybe down to around Childress and Wichita Falls by noon. 86 for us by noon. Tomorrow's high will likely be around 94. It'll be another very warm, humid day with a heat index around 100 or maybe a little bit higher. And by late afternoon, some of those thunder showers and thunderstorms could be coming close to our
our area. I wouldn't say we'd be in the center of things, but maybe we might see a few tomorrow evening, tomorrow night. It is 85 at 10 o'clock, but the temperature humidity index is still 91. As the humidity is 58%, the barometer is rising, wind is south at 15, gusting to 21 miles an hour. Clear skies right now. 4D satellite pictures from last night. Wave of instability in the upper air coming down from northwest to southeast, causing those high winds in northeastern Oklahoma and quite a bit of thunderstorm activity, some hail as well. Just over the horizon in these 4D pictures, some pretty big thunderstorms there too. Let's look straight down. And tonight, not much of that lingers except in extreme northern Colorado. And then from there northward, up into western Nebraska, Kansas, western Kansas, Nebraska, North Dakota, South Dakota, some big thunderstorms linger. A lot of hail in some of those storms earlier today. Well, here's what temperatures look like at 10 tonight. We're 85, 78 there at New Orleans, 74 at Shreveport, 75 at Little Rock. More clouds, more showers in those areas today, holding temperatures down a bit. Today's high temperature was 94, low was 75. The air quality readings for today are good. The pollen count from Dr. Jeffrey Edelglass, 906 grains per cubic meter of air, 888 fungus, 18 grass. Now, have a look at the U.S. The big thunderstorm outbreak last night, dying out this morning, but we can see a new low-pressure vortex coming across there from the Dakotas down into Nebraska, Kansas, northeastern Colorado, and big thunderstorms linger in that area tonight. Here's what things look like under those clouds. That's a cold front accompanied by an upper low-pressure system. That was the vortex, the circulation we saw there. Meanwhile, what we have is just mostly a moist air mass, and as this front gets closer tomorrow, then the thunderstorms will fire a little closer to home. Temperatures at 10 tonight, our time, 50s across the northern border states, 51 at Bismarck, 50 at Helena, Montana. Nice cool night there, and pretty mild and warm everywhere else. Tomorrow in the southeastern U.S., scattered thunderstorms will be the rule. It'll be warm and humid there, of course. In the northeastern states, warm. Thunderstorms moving into Michigan and Indiana. In the middle of the country, the backside of those thunderstorms will be in Illinois. Then there'll be showers across the area from Wisconsin to the Dakotas. In the northwestern states, warm, except mild in the mountains. Showers generally around the area. In the southwest, a heat wave starting in California. It's going to be almost 90 in San Francisco tomorrow, and by day after tomorrow, it'll probably be near 100 in L.A. For us, a partly sunny day, thunderstorms north and south, and we may see a few. Overnight tonight, partly cloudy, 74. Partly sunny, a few storms tomorrow, 94, 75. And then Friday, I think thunderstorm chances increase, high 94. But for the weekend, not quite so hot, partly sunny to sunny, low to mid-90s, and Monday sunshine and around 95. Few thunder showers and thunderstorms tomorrow, and more on Friday. Maybe none for the weekend.
Okay. Well, thank you, Troy. You often hear about preservationists fighting to keep historic buildings from being destroyed, but how about an entire state? The National Trust for Historic Preservation has placed the state of Vermont on its endangered list. The group says unplanned and uncontrolled development, like shopping malls and stores like Walmart and Kmart, threaten to destroy Vermont's rustic charm. The state's governor today signed into law a measure that gives tax breaks to landowners and businesses that maintain historic buildings and preserve open spaces. Coming up next in sports, the Rangers head home with a lot of problems after a disastrous road trip. And we'll meet a young man who's emerged from gangs and drugs to become an Olympic hopeful. Dale is up next.
Trucks are a spiritual thing to me. Something you can depend on. It's just like, you know, my best friend, I guess you might say.
Out on the ranch is where I'm at, and that's where I want the truck to work for me.
I need a truck that's rough like I am.
Introducing the all-new Mazda truck with a 4-liter V6 and a soul to match. The new Mazda truck.
Saddle up and let's go dancing.
Mazda, it just feels right.
Keep on rolling!
Going, why not keep on rolling? And the best way to keep things rolling
is to keep working harder,
to roll back prices.
Roll back, keep on rolling.
Look around, there's a lot more that's a lot less at Walmart.
Gotta keep on rolling, roll back America.
We never stop rolling back prices. Walmart,
gotta keep on rolling.
Always the low price, always.
Tonight, I just want to do what I want to do with one of these from Blockbuster. No phones, no guys, just me and my VCR. So do what you want to do. Make it a Blockbuster night.
Forever Young. Critics say Mel Gibson soars in the high-flying romantic adventure of the year.
Adventure!
Discover the feel-good movie that'll have you cheering for more. Mel Gibson, Forever Young. Look for it on videocassette.
Let's say you're looking for a pickup that combines plenty of space with plenty of savings. Then look at this roomy Dodge Dakota Club Cab. You can get $500 cash back, plus over $2,600 worth of equipment like air, stereo cassette, speed control, and cast aluminum wheels at no extra charge. On a Dakota Club Cab, we're gonna help you save. Your Dodge dealer. We know how to help.
Well, the Rangers only have a couple of problems, really, just offense and defense.
Kevin Kennedy, that pretty much sums it up. Well, Kevin Kennedy's an unhappy guy. The Rangers are supposed to have a day off tomorrow, but a mandatory practice at Arlington Stadium tomorrow morning instead. There will probably be a complaint filed with the players' union, and the Rangers will probably lose, but they should be used to that by now. Ending the road trip in Chicago, the Rangers are losing 2-1, and the White Sox don't have a hit yet. No hits, two runs. Get two hits in the third, the second, a home run by Frank Thomas, and it's 4-1 Chicago. Rangers lose again. 7-4, and now they've lost six in a row. The Angels and Royals are taking turns beating one another in Kansas City. Hal McRae was upset about something. He ends up getting tossed out of the game. California's Kelly Gruber bloops one to center here. It drops in and drives in two. Gruber hits a home run a little bit later, and the Angels are leading in the eighth inning. 8-5. Ooh, 8-7 now. Baltimore wins again. That's 16 of 19 the Orioles have won. They beat Detroit 6-2, and they're still six games back. The Yankees beat Toronto to stop their seven-game losing streak. Minnesota loses again, and Cleveland beats Milwaukee 3-1. Phillies manager Jim Pergosi has a new contract. You manage a team that wins 50 before July, you get one. Playing Atlanta, John Kruk's fly ball to left is there, but Ron Gant can't find it. It drops in for a cheap double and scores a run. Good teams get breaks like that, don't they? Jim Eisenreich gets a base hit. He's got a 13-game hitting streak going. This in a six-run seventh inning, drives in a couple, and the Phillies win again 8-3. And the Giants could get the 50 this week, playing the Padres in San Francisco. They get number 48. Bottom of the third, Kurt Manwaring doubles, and the Giants lead 4-2. Bud Black gets the win. He's 7-1 for the Giants. Their lead is 8.5 now. They beat San Diego 6-2. Cardinals beat Florida 4-3. Colorado wins big 15-5 over Cincinnati. The Mets lose again, and the Pirates beat Chicago 9-4. A lot of young kids in this country fight their way to trouble, then fight their way out of it. Here's another one of those good stories we never do. And here's Susie Woodhams.
His fights are now in gyms. His time spent pounding bags, working on footwork, and moving up in the junior boxing world with dozens of medals to show for it.
And it came out right here on the top.
Yet it's the bullet wounds that remind 16-year-old Jason Basildua how he got on the winning track.
Well, I was into gangs, and I admit I was selling drugs and stuff, but that's because I had nothing ahead of me now. And then my coach inspired me to take myself further because I had talents. And I finally did, and that's when I first went to Junior Olympic Championships.
Winning the 1991 bronze medal in the Junior Olympic Super Heavyweight Division made Basildua want to work even harder at the Dallas Police Athletic League's gym and also in life.
He's learned to show a lot of respect for people and a respect for himself, which I think is very important. His grades have just shot up at school. It's just been an incredible change.
His immediate goal is to win a spot next month on the U.S. Junior World Championship team. But he's also discovered other things, like music.
I get a joy from telling my friends, man, sad as gangs, man. And as a matter of fact, I got a few songs about gangs, positive messages. I help a lot of my friends out by doing that.
I'm proud of my son, and someday he's going to make it to the goalie. That's what he wants, and I hope God will guide him.
His ultimate goal, though, remains in the ring.
I want to make my country proud in the 96 Olympics. I realized that I was going to change my whole life completely. That's when my coach told me, you have talent in boxing, stick with it. So actually I did, and now here I am today.
Susie Woodhams, Channel 8 Sports.
I'm going to take a couple days off. If I can get Troy to change Friday's forecast, I've got Friday's bringing the food and Dash Riprock and the Dragons in my backyard Friday night. And if it doesn't change, you're not invited. So,
He's promising. Thanks, Dave. Now, still ahead on tonight's update, meet a toddler who's managed to overcome some difficult odds. Raymond is tonight's Wednesday's child, and we'll have his story next.